got going is I just bought a 12-foot Meyers aluminum boat. Right now I'm working on getting the registration stickers off, along with the painted registration numbers they had on there. For that, all I'm going to be using is a scuff pad. Get some thinner on this and just thin it down just a little bit so it's a little easier to get off. From there, I'm going to flip it over, do the other side. After that, I'm going to start working on the inside where they had carpet glued down to the floor. I've taken that off. And from there, I'll start removing all the leftover.
All right, here's what it looks like after I use the stripper to get all the numbers off that were painted on. And also the registration sticker. They're gone now, too. It wasn't hard. It took a little bit of time. Other than that, it was pretty straightforward. I'll give you a shot of it, what it looked like before here, just in a sec. Here's a shot of what it looked like before I took all the numbers and registration tags off. As you can see, it was kind of a big mess. They were on there so long that they just adhered to the aluminum. I used a heat gun to heat them up, try to scratch them off a little bit, and then use the Brillo pad to get the rest of it off. The inside is in pretty decent shape. As you can see the line where the glue was. Alright, so like I said, there was a lot of glue left over from the carpet they had in the bottom of the boat. Here's what I'm talking about. You can see all the green stuff. See excess glue that stayed on the aluminum after the carpet was peeled up. I'm just going to go ahead and take some decently coarse sandpaper and go ahead and get rid of it. I'll give you a shot when it's all done. It's going to take a while. It doesn't come up real easy. So I'll let you know what it looks like when it's done. There's my first start on it. I still have a lot to remove. Alright, I'm done with the first section between the front seat and the middle seat. This is how it ended up coming out. I got most of the glue off except for around the rivets. That's pretty tough. Then this is my next section I have to do. It looks bad, but all it is glue. Other than that, the boat's in great condition. Well, I just got done putting it up on sawhorses and filled it with water over pavement so you could see if anything was going to leak or not. After I filled it up halfway with water and got the plug put in, there was no leaks. So I don't have to fix any leaks. It's solid. So go from there, go ahead and just set a couple sawhorses up, throw it on there and fill it up with water, and that way you can tell if you have leaks or if you don't have leaks, if you need to patch anything up or if you don't need to. Most of the sanding is done now, except for the very back portion back here. The floor is still it's dirty and it's got glue on it. So so I've got the boat up on sawhorses. From here I'm going to be sanding the bottom. As you've seen, I've got most of the glue off from the inside of the boat. First off, I'm going to go ahead and use something called wax and grease remover. It's going to go ahead and take off the oxidation off the boat. From there, actually before I do this, let me go ahead and All right, I've completely finished the sanding process except for the seats, which shouldn't take me long at all. This is the bottom after it's been completely done. Tried to use a wire brush around the rivets to really clean it up. And now all I'm going to do is go ahead and give it a bath in soap and water to get everything I can out, all the dirt that's loose. Other than that, there's really not much dirt left. And then once this is done, go ahead and use your wax and grease remover. And after that, we can start using the self-fetching primer.
So right now, what we've got is the boat flipped upside down on some sawhorses. Everything's completely sanded now. The benches, the outside, the inside, we've got all the glue off, all everything off. From here, what we're going to do is go ahead and use our paint prep. It's called for before the self-fetching primer. You don't have to use it, but I would definitely recommend to, because it takes the oxidation off the boat and all the residue you left from sanding off. It gets it off. To apply it, all you're going to do is splash a little bit on your rag. Go ahead and wipe it on. And then before you see it evaporate, you go ahead and you need to wipe it off. Doesn't seem like much, but once you start doing your whole entire boat, you'll get sick of it. But it has to be done for the self-fetching primer to really appear. So I've heard